The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined.
not be afraid. For see, I am bringing to you good news of great joy. You will find a child wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace. Please be seated. Join me in the responsive reading. We light these candles as a sign of the coming light of Christ, as the Lord has promised in days to come. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined.
Grace to you and peace in the name of Jesus Christ, and welcome to worship here at Lafayette Avenue Presbyterian Church. We are a diverse community where people of faith and no faith at all can come together, journey with one another, and experience the divine through openness and honesty, laughter and prayer, music and worship. Whether you're watching at home or you're here in person, it is our joy to have you with us this evening. If you are a visitor, which I'm starting to think a few of you are, we're so glad that you're here. You bless us with your presence. And since you're here and I have your attention, I want to tell you something. We actually do this thing all the time. Maybe not quite like this, a little bit less fanfare, but I want you to know that we would love to have you join us anytime. Friends, tonight is the night. It's the one that we've been waiting for. And for me, it is an honor and a joy to be with you as we wait these final hours, as we begin to see the light that has broken into our world. Will you join me in prayer? Beloved in Christ, it is our duty and delight to prepare ourselves to hear again the message of the angels, to go in heart and mind to Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, the babe lying in a manger. Let us hear again from the Holy Scriptures the tale of the loving purposes of God from the first days of our sin until the glorious redemption brought us by this holy child. And let us make this house of prayer glad with carols of praise. But first, because this, of all things, would be first in Jesus' heart, let us pray for the needs of the whole world, for peace upon the earth, for love and unity, for goodwill among all people, and particularly at this time, let us remember, in word and in deed, the poor, the cold, the hungry, the oppressed, the sick and those that mourn, the lonely and the unloved, the aged and the little children. Lastly, let us remember all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and in a greater light, that multitude which no one can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom, in this Lord Jesus, we pray the words that he taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them hath the light shined. Thou hast multiplied the nation and not increased the joy. They joy before thee according to the joy in harvest, as men rejoice when they divide the spoil. For thou hast broken the yoke of his burden and the staff of his shoulder, the rod of his oppressor, as in the day of Midian. For every battle of the warrior is with confused noise and garments rolled in blood. But this shall be with the burning and fuel of fire. For unto us a child is born, and unto us a son is given. And the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end upon his kingdom and upon the throne of David, to order it and to establish it with judgment and justice, henceforth and even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts.
Thank you. A shoot shall come from the stump of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see or decide by what his ears hear. But with righteousness he shall judge the poor and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. He shall strike the earth with his rod, with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall kill the wicked. Righteousness shall be the belt around his waist, and faithfulness the belt around his loins. The wolf shall live with the lamb, the leopard shall lie down with the kid, the calf and the lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them.
Thank you. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver the child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn.
We have come. that region, there were shepherds living in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace among those whom he favors."
Thank you. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and found the child lying in the manger. And when they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart.
Thank you.
remembers the way things used to be when we were young and Christmas was so easy. You know what I'm talking about? Remember when presents would just appear like magic under the tree? None of these last-minute trips to Macy's that feel like some sort of a capitalist apocalypse. And all those delicious cookies and the holiday hams and the hot chocolate that would just pop into existence for us to enjoy. None of the hours of labor, none of the flour-stained clothes, the unbearably hot New York kitchens. Not to mention, that was back when Mariah could still hit the high notes of her old song. The fact is, things have changed. So has Christmas. Whether it's because for you, like me, you're adjusting to life in your 30s, or to that now it's on you to get all the presents and make all the food and bring this December 25th of dreams to fruition. Or maybe it's that the ones in your life that make you think of the holidays aren't here anymore. Or maybe it's just that the last few years in particular have left their mark. Whatever the reason, I think for many of us, Christmas isn't what it once was. And I think that's right. I think that's normal. Because just as we change, just as our world changes, so does how we show up in moments like this. The way that we experience this season is different than it was last year. It's different from every year before, and it's different from every year still to come. And actually, maybe changing what we think tomorrow is all about, maybe changing how we see things in general isn't such a bad thing. I invite you to listen now for a word from God as it echoes to us from the Gospel according to John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overtake it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or of the will of the flesh or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. John testified to him and cried out, "This was he of whom I said, 'He who comes after me ranks ahead of me because he was before me.' From his fullness we have all received grace upon grace. The law indeed was given through Moses. Grace and truth came through Jesus Christ, the word of the Lord." Almost a year ago to the day, I shared with you the story of my wedding. And I remember mentioning that the only relative who made it to the church that day, which will be 3 years ago on Wednesday, my only family member present was a cousin. Well, I stand before you today to confess to you that I didn't tell you the full story. To be fair, it's never the full story when you hear only one side, even if it comes from a pastor. What I didn't say was that expecting anyone else to be there was actually breaking an agreement that I had made with my therapist. I was kind of in the wrong to be upset, at least so far as my mental health professional would say. And I mean, who doesn't love a therapist that won't let us be the victim just one time? Thanks, Maggie. I should explain. When I came out, it wasn't like in the movies these days, where at first the family is super homophobic, but then after like 78 minutes of insipid Disney Channel plot, everyone is dancing and singing and hugging and waving rainbow flags. I doubt that I have to tell you that real life is far more complicated, especially relationships. And I know that this is the moment when some of our visitors are like, what kind of a church is this? Yes, the minister is gay. Both of our boards are led by women. That's just how we do church. Anyway, I'll never forget that my therapist challenged me during this difficult time of my life was something that she said without even an ounce of sweetness. She said, Morgan, why don't you start by giving your family the same grace that you've given yourself? She said, you know, it took you like 5 years to figure this out. Why not start by giving your parents the same opportunity, the same time frame to adjust? I know myself well enough to be certain that this would have earned her one of my best withering stares. Now, for those of you who haven't been in worship with us in the last month or so, and don't worry, I'm not as judgmental as these robes make me look. Our services tonight celebrate the culmination of Advent. And if you don't know what Advent is, this is a time for slowing down. This is a time for cultivating a deliberate and mindful awareness of the present moment. It's a season that is devoted to waiting and watching for signs of the divine breaking into our world, no matter how small, no matter how slowly. And let the record show that Christmas Eve is still Advent. I share this with you, I tell you this, because I hope that you're noticing there's a lot of talk about light. About a light that came into the world, about a light that the darkness did not understand. And the thing is, I don't believe that it's the kind of light that we're always able to see without careful and intentional looking. What I have found, what I think Advent teaches, is that this light, it's not always the blaze of an enormous bonfire. It's not always a huge spotlight. It's not always even enough glow to illuminate just a small room, but it's there. And the thing about light is that sometimes you won't even see it, at least not clearly and for what it is, if you don't let your eyes adjust first, if you don't let them adjust to the glare, adjust to reality, adjust to a given situation. Speaking from experience here, because although things didn't turn out as quickly or as perfectly as I would have hoped, there is yet to be a rainbow-adorned flash mob, my family has begun to adjust. They're starting to see things differently. On my third wedding anniversary, I see things differently. Actually, this past November, we spent our second Thanksgiving together. My parents, with my husband, with his mother. And if that isn't a glimpse of hope that light is on the way, I don't know what is. And the amazing thing is it didn't even take the full 5 years that I promised Maggie. I'm telling you all of this because if you ask me, if we're only interested in bright displays, if we're only chasing what is dazzling and flashing, we miss out on so much good. We overlook so much subtle grace. We overlook persistent hope. When we don't let our eyes adjust, we can miss out on the kinds of light that, even if they aren't the brightest and the most brilliant, are definitely made of the stuff that the darkness could never overtake. So the only thing left for you to do is think about where you've seen this own kind of light in your own life. And then decide whether you're brave enough to name it. And then decide whether you will share it with us. And because I know how tough it can be out there, I worry that some of you might be thinking, well, there's just no light left in my life. To that I say, with all due respect, I don't believe it. Because even if the darkness that you're facing is bigger than ever, don't let that keep you from risking one more look. You might be like me. You might need a really tough therapist. It might be time to get a spiritual director. It might be time to finally take up yoga, to take up kickboxing, to show up in March in that protest you said that you would. Or maybe, and this is really crazy, maybe come and be part of a church like this one. Maybe be part of any community that will challenge you as much as it encourages you. All I'm asking you to do is find what works for you. Do what you can and let your eyes adjust. Because I promise, the light has shone in the darkness. And the one thing about Christmas that will never change is its insistence that the darkness will never overcome it. Amen.
Thank you.
Friends, this historic church is a place that has long celebrated the light in this world in all of its many forms. This evening, we invite you to support us in that work with a moment of giving. Our ushers will begin to pass the plates for a free will offering, and you may also give at lapcbrooklyn.org/donate. Thank you so much for your generosity in supporting the ministries of Lafayette Avenue Presbyterian Church.
Thank you. stranger, come in, lay down. Let us remove this burden of light that you've carried around for too long. It is not the darkness that has blinded you. But now, free from the glare, you can let your eyes adjust. Now, sheltered from all that knowing, you can sit within these shadows, strange conferring. Together we will light a candle, not to vanquish the dark, but to further articulate it. Here may you find the wisdom of winter. Here may you unlearn the folly of a life that always climbs the mountain, that believes in accumulation, that does not join God as she too lies fallow, as she too opens herself to absence.
Will you join me in the responsive reading? Do not be afraid. I bring good news of great joy. A child has been born for us, a son given to us, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Prince of Peace. In light and in darkness, we need not fear. This evening I told you one story where I have seen the light, even if it took time for my eyes to adjust. And the thing is, I didn't tell you this because I just like to hear myself talk. I told you because Christmas is not only a celebration. Christmas is a calling. Christmas is a charge to name where we have seen the light, share it with others, and live in its glow by the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Please hear the choral response.